So I would like to start. Okay, this is the agenda of the webinar. Oh, sorry, there is a mistake. Here is the proposed activity two. Sorry. So we will start with the recap of the activity four that had a deadline for today. Then the launch of the project work. And as you remember, we left apart the second part of unit one, waiting for having the full online course for students available. So it is available now, so we can catch up that part of unit one. And then there will be a focus on lesson plans and training partners. That will be the focus of your project work. Then, first of all, I would like to make a sort of recap of what was activity four. So today you were supposed to download the template in Word of the course syllabus past B, and you have been asked to describe your own teaching in the pilot course using the information that you currently have at your disposal. Then post in the forum of the activity your draft teaching plan and writing in the text of the post what are the information and what is the information, what are the details that you're currently still missing in order to be able to complete the teaching plan as a whole. So here is the plan for the next weeks. As you can see, we are running a webinar today. And then the other webinar is supposed to be at the end of the course, so in November the 7th, that is a Monday. In this period, we will run in parallel two main activities and three main units, but the activity of project work is transversal to unit 3 and unit 4. So unit 3 is will focus on the lesson plans that has been developed by partners in the framework of NetPath project. And the unit 4 will focus on training patterns as well developed by partners in the framework of NECT. A project to work that is transversal to unit 3 and unit 4 will be presented today and should be delivered individually in 3 weeks, so by the end of the course. There will be a unique reference forum project work for this activity that will be accessible both from unit 3 and from unit 4. So the same link will take you to the same forum. So they are not two different forums, although they are, you can find the link in unit 1 and link in unit 3 and link in unit 4, but it is the same linked in the two areas. Then, as we said, what was unit one? If you remember, unit one was about using iMOOCs, and we developed the first part of unit one, unit 1A, with a sort of exercise that was called discovering the platform. So you have been asked to navigate the platform in order to understand how to use it with the hat of a student. Okay. And we introduced the fact that in the second part of the unit, we will focus on the use of the platform with the hat of a pilot teacher. So in this second part of unit one, we will focus on the analysis of the course that the Medical University of Graz published on iMOOCs, the course that is targeting pilot students, and we will analyze, we will reason about the possibility of to integrate the educational resources that are uploaded there in your own lessons and teachings. As well, the activity 2 will be launched today, and it will have a reference forum in the area of Unit 1 that is called the Forum Activity 2. Any questions till now? Okay. So, now, in this webinar, we will go deeper in what a lesson plan is and what a training pattern is. But just to finalize this overall analysis of the assignments for the next 3 weeks, I would like to point out that both for the project work and for the activity 2, we suggest to perform some preliminary activities. So for the project work, module 3 and module 4, we will invite you to study the lesson plans and the training patterns that have been uploaded in the platform. Lesson plans are in a folder in Unit 3, and training patterns are in a folder in Unit 4. While as to module 1B, we will ask you to analyze the Nectar online course, the one addressing pilot students. So after this preliminary activity, you will be able to perform the project work that is clearly detailed in terms of instructions in a post that has been posted today in the forum of Unit 3 and Unit 4. And what is your project work? You are asked to produce to describe a lesson, a possible lesson in which you will implement as a Nectar pilot teacher one of the proposed lesson plans and or one of the proposed training patterns. So to take one or a couple of them and to try to adapt them in order to shape a lesson that could be integrated in your teaching. To perform this task, we developed a template, so it's a Word document with some titles supporting you not to forget some important information that should be specified when describing a lesson. As to the second activity, you, as I said, should analyze the Nectar online course, and then you will be asked to send a post in the forum of activity 2. As well, for the other activity, you will have a detailed instruction, a post with a detailed instructions for this activity in the forum of activity 2. And in this post, you should explain if and how part of the Nectar online course, for instance, one, two videos or resources that are uploaded there, could be integrated in your teaching, because this course doesn't deal with the whole set of learning outcomes included in our curriculum. So it faces some of the learning outcomes and of the contents of the whole course. So it depends on the specific topic of your teaching, on the specific expertise you have as a teacher to be able to use these resources or not. Because if you teach about hygiene and there's no educational resource about hygiene, is actually impossible to use that lessons for your own teaching. Differently, you can use, for instance, a training pattern because they are, as we will see, transversal to any kind of topic in order to shape your own lesson. We are not providing absolute definitions of what are lesson plans and what are training patterns, because in literature there are many definitions and a lot of suggestions and many resources to be analyzed. And I also invite you to search for them because they are very precious for a teacher. But here we are defining what are lesson plans in NECTAR project and what are training patterns in NECTAR project. And in particular, what is the aim of these tools in our project? Let's start with the lesson plans. So a set of lesson plans has been delivered by NECTAR partners in spring, summer of this year. Okay, these tools are aimed to support pilot teacher, so you, to address some crucial learning outcome of the NECTAR curriculum. So in a first discussion, partners decided what learning outcome could be defined as crucial for us. The reason, so the criteria for the definition of crucial learning outcome were heterogeneous and were concerning, for instance, the fact that they are very important and for the definition of the Chef-Gatter engineer profile, or because they are innovative and so maybe there could be a lack of experience in the background of teachers, of back providers, and so it is important to add new knowledge about them and provide hints about how to address those specific learning outcomes. And also, a sort of relative importance of the team has been considered. Anyway, what are these lesson plans? Are templates for developing lessons that focus on those specific crucial learning outcomes. And they identify, in particular, they start from the description of the learning outcome addressed by the lesson plan, and they try to formalize in terms of suggestions for a possible teacher implementing those lessons, how to address the needed knowledge and how to address the needed skills that are outlined in the learning outcome description. In addition, when possible, they also identify some crucial professional steps or professional activities which should characterize the chef gastro engineer in order to allow the teacher to target them in order to ensure that they will be transferred and reproduced by the students once the learning outcome is achieved in his her daily practice. Here is a list of the learning outcome addressed by the lesson plans. So four partners developed these lesson plans, and each of them developed three lesson plans. So at the end, we have 12 lesson plans, and the addressed learning outcomes are the one outlined in this table. I would like to share with you one example, just to be sure that there is no problem with them. So I choose this one that is, so each lesson plan is formalized in a PDF document, and they follow a specific template that we agreed with partners. So each one has a title, and each one refers to a specific learning outcome. This one, developed by the Medical University of Graz, is focused on learning outcome 2AB3, whose title is Be Aware of the Main Swallowing Problems which raise the need for adapted food and be able to tackle these problems and conditions in daily work in collaboration with health professionals. So that, as I said, the template is the same for all lesson plans. There is an introduction and then the exact description of the learning outcome provided in the curriculum is reported here. So this table is the same you can find in the curriculum in terms of, so the learning outcome is described in terms of the addressed knowledge, skills, and personal transversal competencies. And other important information are provided here in terms of the links to other learning outcomes, the AQF level, and if the learning outcome is mandatory or optional. Then there are specific sessions concerning if there is any particular preparatory learning outcome for this lesson plan. If you remember, we have a flexibility table, a table included in the designer's kit, where some suggestions about the possible educational strategies to be adopted are provided. And here, partners retrieved that information and summarized them in the template for the lesson plan. Then for each specific knowledge addressed in this table, so this one, and each specific skill, partners have been asked to formalize the related contents and possible educational materials that a teacher could use in order to address the knowledge. So a list of contents is provided and suggestions for the educational materials are provided. In the event that a material on the MOOC of so on the online course addressing pilot students is available on the specific topic, they have been asked to point it out, as in this case. Okay, so here is explained that a particular presentation is available there. And then here is suggested, for example, so to perform case-based scenarios, so other activities that support the addressing of the specific knowledge. And here are some here is some text about the suggested activities to address this knowledge. Then, as to the skills, as we said, there is a list of crucial professional steps and activities characterizing the chef gastro engineering that should be addressed through this lesson. And here we have a list. And then other particular hints to address personal and transversal competencies. Here is an example, one out of the 12 lesson plans available for downloading on the platform. So as well, we are defining what are training patterns in our project. A set of training patterns has been delivered by Nectar partners at the same time of lesson plans, so in spring, summer, to implement some to support pilot teacher to implement some best practices for the implementation of innovative educational strategies. So, as I said, they can be applied transversely to lesson plans and generally to the most of learning outcomes included in our curriculum. So, in the event that retrieving the example I put forward before. So in the event that you are a teacher of hygiene and know lesson plan has been developed focusing on the topic you address, and no materials are online available for students about the topic you are addressing. Anyway, you can profit of the training patterns since they are a very precious resource for you in order to shape an effective lesson. And these patterns have been created from scratch by C4Life, referring to some well-known literature about the most used training patterns, but also taking into account the specific context of Nectar, so selecting the ones that could be most effective in this context. And then we referred to the possibility of running lessons both in the face-to-face mode and in distance learning, and we provided hints about which technologies could be adapted to support both these approaches. And also we provided suggestions about the organization of group of students and possible collaborative activities. Then in the final section, some indications about the most suitable learning outcomes for these training patterns are also provided. So here is the list of the provided training patterns. So many of you maybe already know them. So the Jigsaw, the scenario-based learning focused on the critical incident, the web quest, the pyramid, and the brainstorming. So as we did for lesson plans, I show you an example of a training pattern. Again, they are described following a same template, let me say. This pattern is the one about the critical incident. We thought that it would be very useful for the chef gastro engineer course. So since it's focused on the analysis of the practice of a professional. So it is based, each training pattern is based on a general description of the pattern and a focus on when it is useful. So for instance, the critical, I don't know if you are able to see it, maybe I zoom a bit. The critical incident analysis is valid and appropriate when for developing interpersonal skills and self-awareness. So it is available educational technique which enable workers in their role of learners to draw on past experience and make sense of them. Then the focus is on how to implement it. So for each pattern, a number of phases are depicted, but please make attention to the fact that we are talking to teachers. So this is not a resource that you can reuse and with the students directly, but this is a sort of guide for teachers in order to design a lesson based on this pattern. So for instance, here is described a number of phases, identifying, composing the pattern for the development of a critical incident. So for instance, phase one, identifying a critical incident. Learners are asked to identify an incident from their workplace, which they consider significant to their roles as professionals. Then phase two is presenting the critical incidents. So learners are asked to describe what, when, where, and how they identify the critical incident occurred. then they are also invited to identify specific attributes or aspects of the incident, of the specific incident, and they are finally invited to reflect on what happened to them in terms of the learning that they gained as professionals. Normally, they are asked to formalize this reflection, meta-reflection, through a document that is called learning log. And here in this document, the learning log is explained. So it is explained what a learning log is, and there is also a template for the learning log and an example. And then there are other two phases discussing the critical incident. So learners are invited in group to discuss and comment the critical incidents described by the other members of the group. I'm summing up the main characteristics of each phase, but the description is more extensive. And then the last phase aims to bring a theory to make a connection between theory and practice. Then there are some suggestions, very practical, in order to develop these phases online or in presence. And there is a very useful, according to me, table that summarizes what has been written before in terms of the phases and the task for each phases, how should be structured the teams, so the groups, of if the learner is supposed to work individually or in groups, and which is the proper size of the groups, and then hints in the event that the activity is organized face to face in the classroom, so how the classroom should be set up, or if it should be endowed with particular resources, or the needed technologies in the event that the activity or the specific phase is set up online, because maybe you can set up the first and the last phase in presence and the two intermediate ones online in a blended approach. Last but not the least, we have additional comments and some examples in Nectar context. So there are some suggestions about the learning outcomes which could be addressed by the tailoring of the specific training pattern into your own lesson. Then, as I said, there is an example of template for the learning log and an example of a learning log filled in for a specific course. So as to your project work, you're asked to so the detailed instructions for the project work are provided in the forum project work transversal to unit 3 and 4. The link to the forum is available both in unit 3 and in unit 4. Then in unit 3 you will find a folder named lesson plans where you from which you can download the 12 lesson plans available. You're free to decide if you want to download the whole set or only those ones that are more suitable for your topics. Okay, so if you want to see the arguments, you can find it in the list of my slides. So maybe we can share the slides by email if you want, just waiting for the publishing of the video. So we can do this for you in order to allow you to start as soon as possible. And then another folder in Unit 4 named the Training Patterns. In this folder, you can find the five training patterns that we have just analyzed. I only want you to see. Okay. This is the template for the description of your lesson. What's the difference between the teaching that you have just described for activity four and the lesson? So a teaching is the whole teaching you are going to perform inside of the pilot. Okay, that could last, I don't know, 3 days, 4 days, 2 weeks, and it could be made of more lessons. Okay, so this is a specific lesson about a specific content. The teaching, the whole teaching, can be more structured and made of different lessons. Generally, then maybe you have a specific role in the pilot that focuses on one or two lessons, and so you can redimension your contribution, and probably the description of the lesson is similar to the one of the teaching. But generally, the teaching include more than one lesson and an overall approach to lessons, while this one can be the description of a specific lesson based, for instance, on the critical incident template we have just seen a few minutes ago, and so you could focus more on this. So this is just a template, okay? So just retrieving the name of your teaching code, the learning outcome you would like to address, and then you can integrate the description of the lesson more or less based on the template of the training pattern or the lesson plan. And you can or may also use this template. This is optional, just to support you in the event that you adopt and you tailor a training pattern. You can use this template, so the same table provided in each in training pattern, you can adapt, tailor it to your own lesson, and list the educational materials and other additional information and contents. Anyway, support for filling this template in, we are completely available. Where to find this template? The template is not downloadable from the folders, but is an attachment to the post sent with the instruction of the project work. So is you can find it in the form. Last slide is about activity two. Here I directly printed the post I sent in the forum. So today we are launching unit 1B, the one about the analysis of the Nectar online course targeting students. As preliminary activity, as I said, you are asked to register to the Nectar online course. If you search if you use the search bar of iMOOCs, as explained in the instructions for using iMOOCs, if you search for Nectar, you will find the two courses: our course, so the NOT, the Nectar Online Training of Trainers, and the other one, SEFS in Future Integrated Healthcare, that is exactly the course addressing students. As you can see, this is only in English. The other one has a proper translation from each resource that has been uploaded there, in order to support their use with the final end users, so the students. So you are asked to register to this second course, to navigate the course and analyze the provided educational materials. That it is structured exactly like our one, so by units, okay? And then you're supposed to figure out their possible application in one or more lessons that you're going to run in the framework of the pilots that will be run in your country. So the assignment is to send a post in the forum of activity two, explaining, as I said, if and how part of this Nectar online course could be integrated in your teaching. In the event that no resource is addressing the topic you are going to deal with, please send a post again anyway in order to allow us to understand that you have anyway performed the activity, saying that you may, hopefully you have find the resources interesting, but no one of them is dealing with a topic that you're going to address in your lessons.